You may remain standing. Now I come in the ending to set my seal upon your brow, O Chila of the will of God. Here in full presence yet also in Darjeeling, I am the diamond heart of this movement. And I am determined that it shall not fail, for the Chila, one by one, will not fail. I am present in the midst of the eye of the hurricane, as are ye all in this hour, though you know it not, so sealed are you in the great manifestation of the will of God, that is the vortex of light around this community. Therefore, beloved, when you shall go forth on the morrow, go forth arrayed in the armor of Archangel Michael, and do not flinch, and consider failure to be not an alternative. Thus we are in the heart of the ashram, for is not the ashram the nucleus of all energy systems? I indeed it is. Therefore, let us chat together this evening. The accomplishment of the publishing of the ashram notes, we laud. Now we inspire you to understand that this is the foundation of the cone that did begin the Summit Lighthouse. The ashram is ever present. It is a world order. There are many members outside of this community who are my chelas. They uphold the ashramic consciousness, and the Antakarana has been a building for 30, 40 years and more. For the understanding of the ashram as the house of light, the dwelling place of the guru and the chela, gives comfort to all. It is the comfort flame midst the storm. It is the light in the cabin window that is seen afar off by the traveler through the night storm. The ashram is the haven. It is the resting place. It is the place that wherever you find it is the same as every other place. Surcease from the struggle, entering in for the recharge. Brothers and sisters of one mind and heart and purpose, meeting here and there along life's way, in our secluded outposts, such is the vision of the ashram that I hold and that does exist. Therefore, you too have been nestled in that place which many have prepared by the stretching of the Antakarana of a cosmos. Feel now the thread of this Antakarana pass through your heart. It is truly a thread of light. And therefore, if you will tremble the thread by using at least one of the meditations daily, and there are indeed short ones that no one should find excuse to neglect, then you see you will always be a part of the Antakarana. You will always be able to hear with the inner ear and hear with the heart. What is the situation of all servitors of the will of God, of a cosmos? You stand to benefit much from this association, for, admittedly, many are beyond your attainment, some the unascended adepts, others ascended masters and cosmic beings. And therefore, you may deliver to those of lesser attainment their momentum, even while you are strengthened yourselves by that impetus from above. Indeed, the ashram is an impulse. It is an impulse to love and to fulfill the commands of Christ Jesus. We are worshipers of the universal manifestation of the Christ. Yet we are here to fulfill the words of the Savior Jesus Christ, who is Lord and must be seen as Lord by those who would enter the heart of God's will and receive the strength to fulfill it. For without Christ ye cannot. Shorn lambs, yes. Karma bearers, yes. And those who have vested no small amount of energy in other causes that are not of God's will. Therefore, until all of these strands be withdrawn from an investment unwise, you see, you require the intercessor to do the will of God. The intercessor is indeed the mantram, is indeed the meditation, is indeed the ritual. For I and my Father are one. And lo, Christ will whisper to you, I am the Word, and my Word is manifest in you, as you allow that Word to resound through you. And so as you do, beloved, you become first the manifestation of the words of Christ. And then, beloved, millions of words clustered together in a diamond heart becomes the chalice for the word itself, and one day you will know, I too, with Christ, am the Word incarnate, for there is no longer separation between me and my Lord, for I am one in his words. I have drunk his blood. I have assimilated his flesh. And I am that he is where I am. Lo, it is he. Lo, he cometh. Lo, he cometh. Where I am, in the ashram, in the eye of the hurricane. Lo, he cometh. 10,000 of his saints surround me. And I am one. I am one in him and he in me, by the Word incarnate. Thus, the ashram is indeed a means to an end, and that end is total identification with the Word of God. It is the strengthening of hearts that we seek. And ritual has evermore been the means to that end. The ritual itself does increase the capacity of the individual to hold mighty currents of energy. As the capacity does increase, you are transformed. Rituals are self-transforming. Listen as I give them with you through the messenger. Listen to the quality of the voice of Lanello and of myself as you hear the fervor of love and realize that the messenger by example is teaching you how to create from the recitation of the word a chalice for light. The mere repetition of words will not suffice in this pursuit. Every word you speak, even as you hear me speaking now, is put forth with a power, with a fervor of adoration and gratitude to God. In fact, the spoken word does carry all of our being and the stamp of our individuality. So when you recite your rituals, may the sacred fire breath carry into your words the light of your heart. When these words are sent forth, there is no ending to them. They cross the matter spheres and bless all life. Such is the nature of the word of the Guru. Emulate this delivery, beloved, in your ashram rituals, so that your cups of light as conveyor belts shall reach millions of hearts of light, never stopped by distance. For these words given in this fashion travel beyond ordinary wavelengths of sound. There is indeed the light and sound ray whereby the words of the Guru, wherever the Guru is manifest as God in the universe, are carried, and they are shuttled across the skies from star to star. And all who are chelas of the will of God, who have reached a certain level of attainment, listen with the inner ear for the conveyances of the word as power, the word as teaching, the word as love, the word as the exegesis on the law itself and the scriptures. Now understand how the word of Jesus Christ does live forever beyond heaven and earth, for it is beyond these octaves that the word goes coursing on its way, nourishing life and holding the balance of the universal ashram of the devotees of the will of God. Blessed ones, all who have any level of attainment whatsoever must be devotees of the will of God. Thus you begin to see the magnitude of our ashram, that the entire spirit of the Great White Brotherhood is a part of the Antakarana that you enter when, with regular rhythmic cycle, you recite our rituals. In the beginning was the word, indeed, and in the ending is the word as the work of the Lord. And in the middle is the word, and everywhere is the word. Now then, beloved, I assure you that it would please me highly if you should seek out and find those souls of light of a similar wavelength to your own, to bring them the message of the universal ashram of the light of God's holy will, that they might understand that by a little entering in and a little joy in the vibrations that pour through the worded release of our meditations, they might find the true communion of saints and oneness with all who have ever loved the will of God. This strengthening process is necessary, for when you do not receive from the earth currents or the earth itself or its nutrients all that you require for the strength of the body and the mind, for the clarity of perception, for functioning in the capacity of an ascended adept, as you are called to do, then I tell you that the channels that you tie into and reinforce by your words in our meditations will open up to you the energy and the currents of light to make up the difference against the problems of pollution of this world or any other world so contaminated. Our God does not leave you comfortless. Our God can supply you with light and equalize your needs. But if the channels be not open, if they be not sustained, beloved, then when you have need, you are not tied in to the ashram. And through this Antakarana, you experience the direct tie to your mighty I Am presence, when in the karmic state you would not otherwise be able to sustain it. For you are perpetually in touch with cosmic beings. What of the decrees and the decree momentum of many years? All of this does reinforce the rituals. But the rituals are very special. They are very precious. They are foundational and fundamental to all who would begin on the path and run and not be weary and complete their course. The ritual is the means of devotion, and through it and the instructions, you gain certain skill by visualization, by fervor of heart, by will of the mind, and by caring for other parts of life, to send light and to intensify the light ray. As you see it shoot forth from your heart, visualize the intensification of it and direct it for all God good, wherever the need is greatest. Thus meditation will strengthen your vision, and the clearing of the third eye chakra, as you use it more and more to project only good to every part of God's life. The meditations are a dispensation. They come from the causal body of a great cosmic being who has also been my mentor. And through my heart, this release to my chelas does complete a circle that can take you to far-off worlds, the abode of this great being. Thus, beloved, in all ways know that we have many reasons for which we do many things. And though I could speak to you for many an hour on the realities of the ashram and what it can mean to your acceleration on the path, I do request that as chelas of the will of God, you will accept my word that it is so, and that this bonding together of your souls with one another, with my heart, and with all servants of God's will, is a major key in your success and your God victory, even in the matter of the initiation at the two-thirds level of the pyramid, in the matter of the expansion of resurrection's flame in your heart, given to you with such love, such ineffable love by Jesus. Your participation will strengthen you to accomplish all that you desire by a path of self-mastery. Thus, let the community, let the chelas determine when they desire to group together to give these rituals. Let it be the spontaneous will of all. Let their votes be made known and suggestions filed. Thus, we may commune together in these rituals when it is the free, God-given gift of those who participate. May it be your link to the future and the ark whereby the soul may pass over the dark night of the 90s, and be in place in the matrix of the will of God. Trust me that you must be in the earth, yet not of it. Conquer self, establish right livelihood, and if you do not have it as a sufficiency to your life, know that inasmuch as it is one of the requirements of the Eightfold Path of the Buddha, there is some force of the anti-Buddha that you must go after within the self. For right livelihood is the very nature of the path itself, and wrong livelihood will not profit your soul, nor be for the balancing of karma. Thus, if greed or any other vice color your motive in livelihood, you will not be accelerating on the path. Consider then the requirements of the Buddha on the Eightfold Path and bring your lives into proper adjustment. Unless you can call to the five Dhyani Buddhas and earnestly desire the removal of the poisons, unless you can call to Cyclopea for the vision to see what poisons bring ailments to the spirit and the soul and the mind, it is difficult for me to help you. But when you are a part of the ashram rituals, you receive pulsations of my mind, and you enter into your own mind of Christ, and you see these things, and you are strengthened to deal with them, and you will not fall apart when you discover things about yourself that you have not been willing to look at before. The abundant life must be demonstrated by those who espouse the path of embodying virtue. Virtue does lead to the building of the magnet of the heart, and love can only attract more of itself. And the magnet of love does always bring all things necessary to the one who carries that magnet of love to the exclusion of all lesser vibrations. Now in the heart of the mystery school, I am come. The thread of the Antakarana of the ashram I have passed through your heart. Now I make this offer to you to establish a focus of the ashram by your giving of the rituals and seek to expand the circle of your meditation by inviting those who will come and those who would enter in. If you would establish this force field, even if you are alone in your home, if you establish a weekly routine of daily meditations and keep it, I, Maurya, Lord of the First Ray, will sustain for you the matrix of the ashram where you are. If possible, consecrate a place where you give your rituals and keep it holy. Even a little corner of a room will do. Thus, beloved, the ashram always has been and always will be without requirements except devotion. You do not need membership cards. You do not need written pledges or dues or anything else. You have the ashram notes to study and restudy. There are souls in other dimensions who use this little book as a Bible of their entering into the heart of the will of God. The notes give impetus to profound meditation upon God and His Christ. Therefore, they are to be savored again and again. They are like the bittersweet candy in the mouth that will never dissolve, but always be there to savor again and again. The notes will draw those whom you include in your circle into a desiring to know more of the path, more of the Chohans of the rays, more of the Great White Brotherhood. Let them ask, for their cup is full as they receive those notes and do the rituals. Never offer a seeker more than he is ready to receive. Let him be content to glory in the word of God and in his presence, thereby being so suffused and so satisfied, it may take time for him to desire more. It matters not. It is the quality of love in the spoken word that you give that will bring that one to the heart of Christ, and this is our goal. For when one who does not know Christ Jesus comes to that point of love and profound knowing of the Master, all doors of a cosmos can be opened. Thus I, El Moria, with my Chelas, desire, without pushing, without tugging or pulling or forcing, to bring to all whom we meet, morsel by morsel, of the communion cup and of the bread of angels, panis angelicus. It is a piece I love to hear again and again. Whenever you play it, I shall be there. For I love Jesus' sermon. I am the bread of life which came down from heaven. Truly Christ is the bread of life, and one crumb of that loaf is able to transform a universe. Therefore, not in mountains of material, but in the love quality of your heart, will you find yourself being able to offer morsels of that bread of our Lord. And the wine of the Spirit each one shall drink in. For you cannot send forth the word of a ritual unto a cosmos without it returning to you, the light essence of your immortality to be. In truth, with my amanuensis, Mark Prophet, I have opened a door to thousands and millions through the ashramic consciousness. Now, beloved, I have passed the torch. I have given you the key. The book is in your hands. May you let it do the work, and may you be its handmaid, and the handmaid delivering souls to worship their God and to be free to know Christ. This is my plea to you, beloved, for it is the true introduction to the Summit Lighthouse, which is built on this foundation. May you now go about placing that foundation in your lives, for you will need it in the coming days and months. I desire you to know that the time allotted to us is an open span. I shall no longer define it in weeks or months, but I shall define the time available to you as opportunity. When opportunity is taken and fulfilled each day, you yourselves might provide the extensions of time and even the extensions of space. Work while ye have the light, yet always be prepared. Look to the future with hope, but never with confidence in converting the enemy. His jaw is set against the Lord. He will not receive. The conversion of the Holy Spirit, for God simply does not desire to convert the enemy. Therefore, be always watchful, for the enemy has not gone through a metamorphosis to become somehow the Lamb of God. It is not possible. Thus, prophecy has not changed, cycles have not changed, but what you make of them and what your communion of God shall be will indeed determine the term of months or years allotted to you as a cycle to build the new heaven and the new earth, which I am certain you realize is entirely an inner building of the temple of God. Thus, you will have to learn to plan for infinity and to be prepared for the finite world. You must in your own heart sense the timings and the cycles and the limits to your manifestation upon earth. This you can achieve as well by your meditation on the rituals. Go to the heart of God to determine your fate and have a heart for any fate. The future is an open door. You will not control it all, but you will send forth forces of light that may do your bidding as you serve the light. Blessed ones, I do not avoid telling you that you may go forward with your lives, nor do I avoid the subject of whether there shall be war and what shall become of the economy. But I will not cross the line to make definite prognostications. The astrology that you have heard bears consideration, for as you know, it is a mathematical formula of karmic forces as they interplay through this solar system and beyond. Many things can be calculated and foreseen, but what is not foreseen is the intercession of the Great White Brotherhood and the intercession of the unascended Chelas of the will of God. How you take what is given, how you lock your forces with this Antakarana of God, how you increase the resurrection fire, how you do all these things is the most determining factor of all. Not what I say, beloved, but what you say and do will determine the outcome of your life and of this community. Hear it well and know it clearly. Be practical. This is your hour on Earth. Use all 60 minutes of it to the highest good and gain for God, yourself, and all light bearers. What I say in this hour, then, is that opportunity is still at hand, yet the enemy is fast winding about himself the coils of his own karma. And by, he shall reap it, and there shall not be any turning back of it. See then what the light of God can do, and know that only you are the doers in this hour. I remind you of the pay-as-you-go policy of the Brotherhood. What you give us in the decrees offered in my name through the tapes, we will multiply, send back to you, and do for you. Give us the light, the energy, and the decree momentum. Increase your contact with the Brotherhood by the rituals, and you will see what Moria will do for each and every one of you. It is a pact we make with all who are true members by action of our ashram. We will not fail you, beloved. Give us the light. Give us the energy. Give us the will. Give us the faith and trust. And listen with the inner ear to obey our voice. Then you shall see in full grand display of what the brothers in white are capable on behalf of true Chelas. These are my thoughts in this hour, beloved. Watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation, and watch the events of the world's scene. No Chela must ever be caught off guard when it comes to planetary events and cycles and his own personal life. You must be astute enough to anticipate the future by the signs of the times that you read and sense each and every day. Thus I am with you. Thus my presence remains over my messenger, that you might contact me at a more physical level. And I am truly grateful for her service and staying power, as well as for her compassionate heart, even as I am grateful to you for your faithfulness and your striving, and your devotion, and your presence that continually makes possible the activities of this church and the service of the messenger. We of the Darjeeling Council salute you, we encourage you, and we say, onward, Chelas of the sacred fire. Courage, courage, courage. You may applaud for El Moria if you wish. Would you like to sing to him Song 192? Let us do it.